Guys, welcome to the Freedom to Draw Unsolved Mysteries, and I'm your host, John Krupa. And today's case is a stalker. He wasn't a serial killer, but he definitely, make no doubt about it, was a stalker. He picked his girls to be his followers. He stalked them out of the many women in his commune. In the 60s, this is Charles Manson, devious, evil genius, used his powers for bad, not good. He was flamboyant, he was gregarious, he could get you to do what he said. He was no more than a con man. And he was good at it, but he also was a stalker. Let's get into the case of Charles Manson, guys. I'm going to draw him while I'm telling you a little bit about his story. His story has come up in the media once again, because they're talking about freeing one of his Manson family girls, and we're going to do an episode on that, but that's probably going to be tomorrow. But I figured I'd introduce you guys to Charlie here. He's passed away, so his sick, demented instigation, stalking cannot no longer take place. He's passed away. He still has followers, even to this day. Charles Manson, American criminal and cult leader. Leslie Van Houten, and she is the one that they're talking about freeing. Mr. Gavin Newsom is tired of fighting with her, I guess. That's how they say it in the news reports, anyway. Leslie Van Houten, follower of the cult leader Charles Manson, is one big step closer to freedom. Charles Manson follower Leslie Van Houten is one step from being released from prison after California Governor Gavin Newsom said he'll no longer fight for her parole. Charles Manson was born in November 12th, 1934. He was born one state away from Pennsylvania, Cincinnati, Ohio. He died November 19th, 2017, in Kern County, California. He was an American criminal and cult leader. His followers carried out several notorious murders in the late 60s. Their crimes inspired the best-selling book Helter Skelter in 1974. See also the Tate murders if you want to know more about that. Manson was born to a 16-year-old girl and a man he would never know after his mother was in prison for armed robbery. He lived with an aunt and uncle in West Virginia. Beginning at age 9, he spent much of his life in juvenile reformatories or in prison for crimes that included petty larceny, armed robbery, burglary, and auto theft. It is interesting to know that this man really never committed the act of murder. but he got a lot of people to do it for him. And he picked them. He had many women following him, and he had a lot of women to choose from. So he picked them. He picked the gullible ones, the ones that were naive. So that is definitely in the realm of stalking. He saw them in the ranch. He observed them over a period of time, and he picked them, handpicked them, to be his followers. Now, he gets lumped in with the serial killers, but he wasn't technically a serial killer. That's a misconception with Manson. And here is the swastika that he carved into his own forehead, which is quite a crazy act in itself. Definitely crazy guy, almost mythical proportions. Following his release from prison in 67, Manson moved to San Francisco. Where he attracted a small but devoted group of followers from among the city's bohemian youth culture. By 1968, he had become the leader of the family, a communal religious cult dedicated to studying and implementing his eccentric religious teachings, which were drawn from science fiction as well as the occult and fringe psychology. He preached the coming of an apocalyptic race war that would devastate the U.S. and leave the family in a position of dominant power. He said that the black people would win the race war, but when they came to power, they wouldn't know what to do with it, and eventually they would come back to the white man to help, and that's where he was supposed to be taken over, and that's where he was going to dominate. But it never happened. It was all in his fantasy, in his own mind. And now we're going to switch it up a little. We're going to listen to Rupert Holmes, the Pina Colada song. Why? Because it's National Pina Colada Day. What other song could you listen to on National Pina Colada Day? Manson's hold over his followers was graphically illustrated in 1969 when the family carried out several murders on Manson's orders. The most famous victim was actress Sharon Tate, wife of film director Roman Polanski, who was killed in her Los Angeles home along with three guests. The ensuing trial of Manson and his followers in 1970 attracted national attention. In 1971, Manson was sentenced to death, but following the abolished death penalty and capital punishment in California in 1972, his sentence was commuted to life in prison. He became eligible for parole in 78, but was denied then as well as in numerous subsequent hearings. The murders inspired numerous books and movies, both documentary and fiction. As as we listen to the Pina Colada song by Rupert Holmes. This man was definitely charismatic. He had to be. I don't know how you would get anybody to follow you if you weren't. He's been compared to David Koresh. My opinion, small man, weak man, coward, con artist, had to get people to do his bidding for him. Never was really impressed with Manson, but he is quite an interesting character if you listen to him speak. That's what he was really good at, was throwing the bull. In addition to Helter Skelter, which was co-written by the prosecutors of the murder trial, books included the biography Manson, The Life and Times of Charles Manson, 2013, by Jeff Gwynn. And member of the family, My Story of Charles Manson, Life Inside His Cult and the Darkness That Ended the 60s, in 2017, by Diane Lake, former member of the Manson family. Film and television adaptations include Helter Skelter in 76 and Quentin Tarantino's fictional Once Upon a Time in Hollywood, 2019. And the documentaries Manson Speaks, Inside the Mind of a Madman, 2017, Inside the Manson Cult, The Lost Tapes, 2018, and the 2020 miniseries Helter Skelter, An American Myth. So it tells you about Sharon Tate a little bit, but we're talking about Manson. So his early life, and here's an article I found. Who were the followers known as the Manson family? In the public's imagination, the Manson girls, as they came to be known, loomed almost as large as Manson himself. Mostly young women in their late teens and early 20s. Manson family members were in the late 60s. Not especially unusual. White, middle-class women all over the country were heading for cities like San Fran and L.A. Inspired. Inspired by the hippie generation. Inspired by the hippie generation. And here is a article I found from 2017 when he died. Charles Manson, the wild-eyed 1960s cult leader whose follower committed heinous murders that terrorized LA and shocked the nation, died Sunday of natural causes, according to the California Department of Corrections. He was 83. His diminutive and charismatic Manson orchestrated a wave of violence in August of 69. That took the lives of 7, spawned headlines worldwide, and landed him and his Manson family of followers in prison for most of the remainder of their lives. Manson served 9 life terms in California's prisons and was denied parole 12 times. His notoriety, boosted by popular books and films, made him a cult figure to those fascinated by dark, apocalyptic visions. He still has followers to this day, even though he died. Craziness. Goes to show you people will follow anything. They're gonna follow this psycho. He was the dictatorial ruler of the Manson family, the king, the Marahaha, and the members of the family were slavishly obedient to him. Former Manson prosecutor Vincent Bogolosi told CNN in 2015, to the point that they would kill for him. Brutal killings began on August 9th of 69 at the home of actress Sharon Tate and her husband, famed movie director Roman Polanski. He was out of the country at the time. The first set of victims were Tate, who was 8 months pregnant, a celebrity hairstylist named Jay Sebring, coffee fortune heiress Abigail Folger, writer Wojcik Frykowski, and Stephen Parent, a friend of the family and a caretaker. The next evening, another set of murders took place. Supermarket executive Lino LaBianca and his wife, Rosemary, were killed in their home. Although Manson ordered the killings, he did not participate. And Manson probably got the most significant amount of prison time for never actually committing a murder. He started out as a con man, and I believe he just had psychotic episodes where he started believing his own cons. Over the course of 2 nights, the killers inflicted 169 stab wounds and 7 .22 caliber gunshot wounds. Both crime scenes revealed horrifying images and few details linked to the two. The word pig was written in the victim's blood on the walls of one home and the front door of another. There was also another phrase apparently scrawled in blood, helter skelter. It was misspelled, helter. The reason for the disturbing writings, prosecutor argued, was because Manson wanted to start a race war and hoped the Black Panthers would be blamed for the killings. On June 16, 1970, Manson and 3 of his followers, Susan Atkins, Patricia Kramrickle, and Leslie Van Houten, went on trial in L.A. All those details came tumbling out in the trial that both mesmerized and horrified the nation. During the trial, Manson and his followers created a circus-like atmosphere in the court, with singing, giggling, angry outbursts, and even carving X's in their foreheads. Somehow this guy got these women to go to the ends of the earth for him. And that's a mystery too to this day how he did that. To kill for a man that kind of treats you like a pimp with a prostitution ring. That's some feat. I don't know how he ever pulled that off. People will think this is kind of a drawing, but this is really what he looked like, and he really did have a swastika carved into his forehead. It's not just an artistic representation here, guys. This is actually what he looked like. The charges came after a major break in the case when Atkins, who was already in jail on another charge, bragged to a fellow inmate about the Tate murders. She said they did it because we wanted to do a crime that would shock the world. Manson was originally sentenced to death, but the death penalty was briefly abolished in the state, and his concurrent sentences were commuted to life in prison. He was also convicted in the connection with the killings of Gary Hindman, a musician and stuntman, Donald Shorty Shea in 69. As we listen to the Pina Colada song, this guy was definitely a madman and a stalker. Someone you didn't want to mess with. Very charismatic, though, I'll give him that. He got all these women to do this stuff for him. As we listen to the Pina Colada song. Pina Colada song was made in the early 80s. Not many people realize that. Me being one of them, I thought it was a 70s song. The very early 80s was the Pina Colada song. The so-called Manson family made a dilapidated old movie set called Spawn Ranch near LA, their home. I was mesmerized by his mind and the things he professed, Manson family member Leslie Van Houten once said. At the ranch, Manson was 5'2" tall, and he hosted LSD-fueled orgies and gave sermons. His followers were in the thrall of Manson, who told them he was Jesus Christ and the devil rolled into one. They worshipped Charlie like a god, former Manson family member Barbara Hoyt told CNN. But I heard it wasn't really all just sex all the time. They had a lot of domesticated things to do, like cleaning the house, doing laundry, and getting food, preparing the dinners, stuff that like a housewife or a stay-at-home dad would do. So it wasn't all just sex all the time, like Hollywood wants you to think. Hollywood likes to do that. And he would sing to them. He was a musician. Definitely that helped fuel the brainwashing. Alright guys, well, we listened to Rupert Holmes' The Pina Colada song. We're finishing up drawing Manson here. As he sticks his tongue out and the swastika blazing. This guy was too much. That's about it. That wraps it up, guys. We'll see you on the next episode of the Freedom to Draw Unsolved Mysteries. Peace out, guys. And listen to Rupert B. Holmes as we close out the show.